Country legend Reba McEntire has owned homes across the US from Tennessee to California. For years, she lived in a spectacular Southern Manor mansion outside of Nashville. However, after her divorce, she sold it and offloaded her Beverly Hills mansion for a whopping $22 million in 2015 as well. After severing ties with her ex-husband along with their real estate portfolio, Reba put that profit towards a new home. The singer has kept her current property largely under wraps, but she's thought to live in another Nashville area estate, and she's shared some peeks of it on social media. Today, we're gonna check out a few of her stunning properties. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. Reba McEntire, also known as Reba, is a country music singer, actress, and businesswoman, often referred to as the Queen of Country, since she sold over 75 million records worldwide. She starred in the self-titled TV sitcom Reba, which aired for 6 seasons, and also owns multiple businesses, including a clothing line. At the time, she has an estimated net worth of about $95 million, and Reba's lived the life of luxury to go with that success. When Reba isn't busy working or expanding her empire, you can find her laying low at one of her beautiful properties, fit for a country queen. Her longtime waterfront Tennessee mansion was sold after her divorce from Narvel Blackstock, but since then it's been converted into an upscale event space. And that's only one of her gorgeous homes over the years. Hey guys, it's Kara the Vampire Slayer, back with another exclusive house tour here on Famous Entertainment. Today, looking at what Reba McEntire calls home. Don't forget to like this video, hit that subscribe button if you haven't, and follow me on Instagram to chat. Now let's get into this video. After Reba's divorce, she put her most well-known mansion on the market, which was located in Lebanon, Tennessee, an area about 25 miles from downtown Nashville. The country star put the home up for $7.9 million in 2016, while a year later, a portion of the property was sold to a local businessman for a reported $3.1 million, and these days, it serves as an events venue. The mansion has been completely renovated over the years, while still maintaining its traditional Southern charm, and inside, it boasts a whopping 12,819 square feet of space. The flawless colonial mansion is made up of 13 acres of private property, 8 beds, and 7 bathrooms inside, and it looks like something straight from a movie. Of course, looking at photos, we can see plenty of reasons why Reba and her family would have loved this property. There's a massive chef's kitchen with double-sided fireplace and sprawling rooms to entertain, like the ballroom and family rooms. The property is also known as the Estate at Cherokee Dock or Starstruck Farm, and sits on a beautiful lakefront lot with dock access to the beautiful old Hickory Lake. One of the first things you'll see when walking into the main mansion is the grand 3-level staircase that would be the perfect photo op. Alternatively, you could take the in-house elevator to move floor to floor. There are endless entertainment options here, such as a wine room, movie theater, and fitness center. And that's just inside the home. Outside, you can find everything from a swimming pool and spa to a fire pit and perfectly kept garden. Now Reba's one-time residence serves as a stunning wedding and event venue, and if you're willing to spend around $3,000 a night, you can access all of those amenities and more. Even play a game of tennis on the court, ride horses at the equestrian facility, or catch some Z's in Reba's former guest house. Up to 16 people can stay overnight in the main mansion, with each bedroom designed in honor of a different country legend, including Dolly Parton, Patsy Cline, Willie Nelson, Johnny Cash, and more. The master suite is obviously dubbed the Reba Room, and here you'll find an almost 360-degree view of the woods and lake from the windows. For more intimate cocktail parties or dinners, you can even rent out the barn, which has room for 50 guests, and boasts a rustic elegance, and for outdoor functions, one can use the pool house. This space features floor-to-ceiling windows and French doors, and then you can take a dip in Reba's former pool. In 2015, a newly single Reba and her ex-husband offloaded their Beverly Hills estate in an off-market deal for a whopping $22.5 million. Online sources show the country music and sitcom star snagged this gated and fully landscaped estate in Beverly Park way back in 2003 for $9 million. The world-renowned Beverly Park enclave has become even more exclusive in recent years, which could partly be the reason behind the massive sale. But either way, Reba and her ex had plenty of
of profits to split.
The 1.8-acre property was constructed in 1993, and once inside the home, the mansion opened into a massive multi-level entry hall. In total, her home spanned 9,242 square feet of space, with 6 beds and 7 baths throughout, with grand living spaces as one would expect. The foyer led into the formal living and dining spaces, and an especially spacious family room had an oversized fireplace and a semicircular wet bar to one side. Other features of Reba's luxury mansion included an office, a den billiards room, maid's room, and a wine cellar. The eat-in kitchen here was done up in a sparkling white with some stainless steel appliances, and it also had detailed ceilings that were also present in the dining room. Reba's one-time master suite offered its own large fireplace and soaring ceilings that continued into the attached bath, and there was also a private balcony overlooking the gardens. The spa-style bathroom had a chandelier, built-in soaking tub, double vanities, and more. The grounds of the estate were just as amazing, and there was a second structure back here, which added an extra 2,000 square feet of space. This entertainment area included a lounge and dining area, a bar, a full kitchen, and indoor barbecue setup. The property also had a glamorous Grecian-style pool with reflection ponds and a lighted tennis court. After Reba sold that impressive estate for over $22 million, as well as the waterfront manor near Nashville, she's kept her current properties more private. However, it's assumed the country star lives in Nashville or surrounding areas, and she's given a few peeks inside her home here and there over on social media. Reba revealed her work from home setup at one point when she was prepping for interviews in the kitchen. She stood by the breakfast bar, and we can see she's decorated with wooden and leather bar stools as well as marble countertops. Her kitchen also offers vintage cream-colored cabinets, display shelves, and a large stainless steel fridge. This room leads to her dining area, where there's floor-to-ceiling windows, as well as a wooden table. Reba's living room, on the other hand, features a plush cream-colored sofa, and we caught a look when she posted a clip in 2020. She also has cozy accents here, like a wooden side table, lace tablecloths, and a Christmas tree with white crosses. It seems Reba kept that tree up all year, because this was seen in September. Alright, so that's all I got for Reba McEntire's homes. We may not have been able to see much of her current estate, which she keeps largely under wraps, but her former homes are enough to prove how successful the country star is. Out of her two extra lavish homes, the one in Beverly Park and the one in Tennessee, which did you prefer and why? I think both are beautiful, but I prefer the one near Nashville because it's right on the water, which I think gives the place an extra peaceful vibe. Be sure to let me know your thoughts on Reba's former palaces down in the comments. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give me a follow on Instagram and tell me which celebrity homes we should take a look at next. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye!